Good evening. Tonight we're going to prepare these chicken patties with a side of couscous fresh salad. These are very Russian chicken patties. They were my family for generations now. I used to love them when I was a kid, and I learned them, learned the recipe right away as well. And also an interesting fact, when I first met my husband, now current husband, onto our first date, I made a huge batch of these, and he ate them all. And I, from now on, swear by them being the love potion. So if you wanna wow your partner or your lover, someone you just like, make these for them. Unless they're vegetarian, of course. And I'm pretty sure they're going to love them. So I hope you give it a try. It's quite an interesting recipe as well. We'll take a look at it in a second. And we're serving it with a side of couscous salad with spinach, ricotta cheese, tomatoes, basil leaves, and basil pesto sauce. So, I hope you'll appreciate it and enjoy it, and I thank you for watching. So, here are all of our ingredients. For the patties, you're going to need about 2 pounds of ground chicken, preferably natural, premium. And I like to use lean portions too, so about 96% lean in this case. Another one of the main ingredients is white bread. Now I'm using artesian bread, round sourdough. It does not have to be sourdough, it can be any type of white bread. About 1 pound of it, so 1 pound of bread onto 2 pounds of chicken. You also need some milk, and I prefer to use real milk for this recipe specifically, and either reduced fat milk or whole milk is fine. You will end up using just about 1 cup of it, so you don't need a whole carton if you don't have to get it. Then we'll need 2 eggs. And our spices, we'll need salt, garlic powder, pepper, paprika, or paprika, whichever way you call it, and onion powder. So that's for the patties. Now for our salad, side dish, we're going to need baby spinach, tomatoes. You can use any tomatoes you want. I prefer to use multicolored ones as they bring brightness and vibrancy to the salad to look fresher. Then we'll need about 1.5 cups or a little less of couscous. Some basil leaves if you wish to add them additionally. Some reduced fat feta cheese. Or you can use mozzarella cheese as well. Really, any cheese is fine. And we also have basil pesto sauce that we'll use very little of. You're actually welcome to use any of your favorite salad dressings and just cut up pieces of basil into it. You'll be just as good. I simply enjoy the taste of actual pesto. Okay. So we'll start with cooking our couscous and starting to prepare the chicken patties. Okay. smells so good. So the very first thing we're going to do is we need to use the inside, so the mushy part, the white part of the spread. Pull it into the bowl. We don't need the crust. I do most of the time do things with my bare hands when I cook. Make sure to clean them and wash them very well. Break it into pieces. Try crumbling it a little bit. The next step is us adding some of this milk. So let's add it just all around. I used almost the whole thing. I wanted to break it apart like this. Mix it with milk. See, I even added a little too much milk. We need to make it fall apart into small, small granules. And as you can imagine, it's going to mix up with our ground chicken and make a perfect consistency. So we added both packages of our chicken in here, and now we're gonna add spices. I'm usually adding spices by an eye, so to say. Usually try to cover a thin layer over top. It usually ends up being just enough. Garlic powder. And now we'll need to mix it all up together nice, make it a nice consistency. Okay, let's start. I'm doing this with my hands, so don't be crossed out. So now our chicken patties are ready to be formed and fried. So now on a well-oiled, warm pan, we're going to start putting our chicken patties. If you've ever worked with ground meats, they get stuck to your fingers very easily. So what my grandmother taught me is having a little bowl of water next to you and just watering your fingers in between. So we'll just take little amounts like this, just roll them in between your fingers. Just lay it onto the pan like so. You can make them as big or as small as you wish. You can make them flat and round, like big dollars, like big dollar, you know, shape. Or you can do like me and do them at least fish shapes. This. It is a very, very tasty dish, I have to say. My mom used to make them not so often when I was little. So now that I'm grown up, I really miss this taste. And I believe that my grandmother used to make these all the time too. unfortunately. But I remember she used to be a mean cooker. She was a very good cook. Okay, I think we have one more spot here. Maybe a smaller one. Little baby chicken patty. Alright, that looks good. So I cooked them for about 4.5 to 5 minutes on one side, covered. Then I flipped them over and I'm going to let them cook for another 5 minutes or so, or until it's more brown on the underside, so they're nice and blushy. So now we're going to prepare our salad, and we're going to slice these little tomatoes in halves, just like so. You can do it long ways or fat ways, wide ways, whichever way you like. Make them smaller into bite-sized tomatoes, so that when you take a bite, it's nice and filled with different ingredients. Okay. And we're going to roughly chop the basil leaves into small, small pieces. We'll cut them, okay? I like to bunch them up and very carefully cut them up. So, into our prepared couscous, going to add some basil pesto. I think about a spoon for a start, maybe two. This seems to be good. Okay. Then we'll add our chopped tomatoes and basil. Refrigerator for a little bit for better taste, and then try it out. It already looks delicious and smells delicious as well. You can always add other spices or other sauces if you wish, or just leave it this way, or add olive oil if you wish as well. I'll leave it this be as it is right now. So now let's taste it all together, see what we came up with. Thank you. So here's our plate, looking very delicious. The salad has cooled off, the chickens are nice and warm still, so let's give it all a taste. I'll try the couscous first. Just have this tomato, some ricotta cheese piece right here. Okay, ready? I really like how all the juices mixed together. You can taste basil a little bit of tomatoes, freshness from the basil pasta as well. Very nice, I enjoyed it a lot. Now let's try the star of the show. Honestly, have been some of the most favorite recipe of mine. They taste so good. They're not kosher at all. And not probably great for your diet. But they taste incredible. Oh my gosh. Not to give myself some props, but honestly, it's amazing. I got a little hungry while cooking with you, so I really need to sit down and eat all of this now. So thank you for watching. I hope you'll give it a taste and let me know how it is. Maybe you'll be surprised by a new little recipe. Thank you.